Hi there. This video comes with some exercise files and a cheat sheet for Photoshop. There'll be a link in the description for those. Okay, it's part of my larger course, which you can go and check out. There'll be a link there as well. All right, enjoy the video. All right, to make this work, we're gonna have to do a little bit of a hack. And what I mean by that is that there's some skills you're gonna learn further in the course, things like smart objects and layer masks, which are gonna make this a very perfect, non-destructive, professional version of what we're just about to do. But we don't have those skills, so we're gonna do a big old hack version where it works, but it may be not the most professional use. So what we need to do is kind of smush all of this together. Okay, so at the moment, it's all separate layers and stuff. We need to kind of smash it into one layer. And to do this quick and easy at the moment, what we're going to do is we're gonna leave, I've saved this version I'm up to. It grays out when it's already saved. So if you're like, man, it won't let me save, it's because you've already saved and nothing has changed. Watch, I move it, and then it goes, hey, I get to save it again. Okay, so I'm gonna undo that. So let's save your document, and then let's save a backup. So let's go to save as, so we're gonna keep that one original with all the layers so I can do adjustments. Now, I'm gonna go onto my desktop, I'm gonna call this one hacked postcard. It's not hacked, it's just, we're doing it the bad way. Let's click okay. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to layer and we're gonna go to this one that says flatten image. And you can see all my good work and all my separate layers have gone. I can't separate them out. That's the bad bit. The cool bit though is it allows us to do the drop shadow and kind of moving it around. First up, we need to, we have that kind of continued problem with background and it's locked. So just name it. I'm gonna call this one my postcard. So that's phase one, it's got rid of the lock. Next one is we need to expand the background a little bit. So the easiest way is under image and go to canvas size. Canvas size, think of it as your page size. So at the moment we are using inches, okay, 6x4. I want it to be a bit bigger either side. So how much bigger? Maybe 1.5 inches, 1.5. Oh, what was that, 5.5 either side? Okay, and click okay. I've just got a bit of extra background now. Cool, so next thing I wanna do is add a background behind it. Okay, so I'm gonna make a new layer. It's this little turned up page here. I'm gonna call this one my background. With it selected, I'm gonna say I wanna go to edit, and I'm gonna go to fill. So I'm gonna fill that layer with what color? I'm gonna fill mine with black. You might say foreground, background. You can pick a color. I'm just gonna pick black, click okay. And problem with the layer order is obvious now. Background's at the top. So click, hold them, drag them underneath. Now what I wanna do with this, you could have just picked a solid color. Okay, what I wanna do is add my gradient that we did earlier, because remember, I'm overdoing gradients all the way through this course. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go down to effects. I've got that layer selected, effects, and I'm gonna go to gradient overlay. And it's remembering the default that I had, okay, from the last one. But remember, if you click on the word gradient here, you can double click these two little houses to pick new colors. But that's in an earlier tutorial. Jump back and check out the gradient one if you wanna know more about it. What I might do is change the direction a bit. And I'm gonna lower the opacity. Lowering the opacity in this case, because there's black as my background color, it's gonna kind of darken it up, because these are the black, and I'm just kind of raising it up a little bit. Find where you wanna be. Click okay. Now we're gonna use our drop shadow and rotation. So click on postcard, let's rotate it. You could go to edit transform, use rotate, but now we're using super duper shortcuts. Remember, which is it? You can't remember. It is command T on a Mac or control T on a PC. Okay, and not there, just a bit further out, click, hold, and drag. I don't know why it's on the angle, it's like, I don't know, just thrown down in a casual but professional way, I don't know. Not sure why it doesn't work that way, it has to be on that kind of lean. When you finish, hit return on your keyboard or enter, and now we're gonna add our drop shadow. And yeah, there's not gonna be much more than that. That's what we're gonna do. We're learning it now because it's gonna be part of your homework in the next video. So hang around if you like. I'm just gonna add a nice big shadow, opacity up, distance up, play with the angle, size-wise. Look at that, beautiful. I never play around with the spread. You'll see, it's not why, like it's just, it's like the choke. It just kind of moves this kind of drop shadow further out. I just never use it, you might love it. Click okay. That's our little gangster lean. We are now gonna add a bit of text and get onto the next video. Totally skip ahead now, because I am just gonna add some text. But you can stay if you like. This is like a client presentation, right? So I'm gonna say my super duper client is going to be, actually I'm gonna keep these on all separate line. Actually I'll put a return in client and project. What I'm going to do, select them all. I'm going to say they're right aligned. I'm going to use a different font. Musio, I've been using through this font course. You don't have it probably. It's a font you can download from Typekit if you want to go and do that. It's part of your Creative Cloud license. I'm not going to cover it all now, but I'm going to use a slab. It comes in a slab version as well, which I like. So I'm going to go to the light version. I'm going to grab the font, lower it down. The leading. I'm going to do the leading here. Not so much leading. Not so much font size either. Yeah, that'll do it for me. Cool. I'm going to duplicate this. Now we've been using the right click duplicate. I'm going to share a little secret. If you hung around, you get the super secret. Okay, watch this. Click, hold, and drag it to the new window, and it makes a duplicate and gives it the name copy. Cool. And there he is there. Awesome, huh? Pays to hang around sometimes. I keep telling people to go disappear, and then I give you a super secret trick. All right. So this one here, I'm going to use the 700, 8900. And the client for this one is going to be Scott Shoes. And the project's going to be their spring sale postcard. I'm reluctant to date these things because I've got stuff in my portfolio that's like 10 years old. It's just holding on in terms of being okay to add to that, still add to it, but it might be a big client or I just want to hang on to it, so I don't date them. What's going to date this though is the gradients. You know, I think I'm catching the end of this gradient phase as well. I feel like the whole Instagram gradient filter type thing is going to be dead in a little while, whilst my portfolio is gradientastic. All right, so that's going to be it for this video. Next video, we're going to set a project for everybody. Let's jump into that and do it now. Hi, it's me again. If you enjoyed the video, a thumbs up really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to my YouTube channel because I release a video like this every week. Also know that this is part of my larger course. Okay, so this is like a free part of it. There's a larger course called Photoshop Essentials. So you could go check that out. There's a link in the description for that full course. Also know that there's exercise files. Those are free to download. Go check that out, link in the description. Another link in the description will be the cheat sheet. So I make it like a PDF cheat sheet for Photoshop with all the tips and tricks you can print off and stick next to your computer and be more awesome. Link in the description. Yeah, all right, that's enough. Hi, Dada.